Hey there, welcome back to my channel. I have my November empties today. So these are the products that I've used up in the month of November, and I'm just gonna let you know my thoughts on them and if I would repurchase them or not. So let's get into it. I'll do candles first. The first candle I went through was the Bath & Body Works Pumpkin Pie. This is from last year. I really did like this scent, and I don't know that I would repurchase it right away. I think if it came back, like maybe 2 years from now, I would probably get a backup of this. Or if I saw it at the semi-annual sale for, you know, $5 or whatever, then I would probably grab another one. It was nice, but I have other scents that I like better than pumpkin pie. The most recent candle I burned up was the cinnamon caramel swirl. And I thought this one was going to be actually too strong for me. Smelling it on cold, it seemed like it was going to be similar to Summer Boardwalk from Bath & Body Works with just a super intense throw, but honestly, I couldn't smell it. It had a terrible throw. On cold, it was super strong, but it just didn't throw. I don't know what the problem was, so I won't repurchase that scent. I went through a DW Home Honey Pumpkin candle. These candles last a really, really long time, and it burned pretty well, too. So I think this was nice. Again, this exact scent I wouldn't necessarily purchase again. I got this at TJ Maxx for $7.99, but I would definitely purchase more DW Home candles from TJ Maxx especially. I went through this Twisted Peppermint. This was just a little mason jar guy. This was probably the perfect size because Twisted Peppermint tends to be pretty strong when you burn it. And so I actually burned this in my living room, which we have pretty high vaulted ceilings, and it's kind of an open concept, and I could smell it throughout the entire main area of the house. So love Twisted Peppermint. We'll definitely purchase that one in the future. I went through a pumpkin apple. I think this is from this is from this last year, like last winter, I believe. Yes, at the same, I don't remember, a couple years ago, I think. Anyway, they have it most years, and it's a great scent. It's one of my favorite fall scents. Just a really fresh, great, like September, October candle to burn. So I definitely will repurchase more of those. I went through this itty bitty pumpkin pie. So what I have discovered that I do with these little candles is I stick them in my freezer and then pop them out. Typically, like if you kind of loosen them up with a knife, or sometimes if you just shake them like this, the wax will come right out for you. And then I burn them in my wax melter. So I find that the throw is excellent when I do it that way, whereas if I burned a candle this size, like in my kitchen or something, I wouldn't be able to smell it. So I think moving forward, if I get these itty bitty candles, typically I won't buy these. I'll just get them when they're free, you know, with a coupon or something. I think that's what I'm going to do moving forward, is just melt those little guys. And I did the same thing with this pumpkin pecan waffles. Just stuck it in the freezer and then pulled the wax right out. That's a tip for you. I think that's all my candles. Let's just do Bath & Body Works soaps. I think I have three of them. So the first one, and I prefer the gentle foaming hand soap as opposed to the other kind, like the jelly kind. So I got the Fall Lakeside Breeze. This was a really fresh scent, crisp morning air. They had this last year. I loved that one. And Comfort and Joy. And I would repurchase all of these, actually. I thought they were all really great. And I just love the packaging for Bath & Body Works. It's really fun and festive. I love having that out in my house. Okay, I went through some bulbs. So I used up my last, this was a two-pack of cinnamon stick of the Wallflower from Bath & Body Works, and I used up my last one. However, I didn't actually finish it, and I didn't even use much of it. So, it's in here, I can show you. And I hate throwing it away, but I had this in my Wallflower, like when I was pregnant with my son, just very early on, and I was sick quite often. And so this scent actually makes me nauseous now. So I'm just not going to mess around with it and just get rid of it, because nobody's got time for that. And I've got a ton of Wallflowers to get through. So no more cinnamon stick for me. I went through, I went through a lot of Bath and Body Works stuff this month. That's great. I went through one triple or 24-hour moisture body cream. I prefer this over the lotion, and this was in the scent Champagne Apple and Honey. And this was a nice scent. This was from this fall that they came out with. It was just fresh, nice. I probably won't purchase this at the semi-annual sale if I see it. I am interested, though, in trying the pear and brown sugar one that came out this fall because I didn't pick any of that up during the season, and I've heard great things about it. So if I see that at the semi-annual sale, I'll probably grab a body cream and probably a body wash in the pear and brown sugar, but not this one. But it was nice. If you don't have it and you like apple scents, I would definitely sniff that one out. And the semi-annual sale starts the day after Christmas, if you don't know that. Okay, what else from Bath & Body Works? I went through a body spray. This is in the old packaging, and excuse the makeup on it. And it's in the scent Carried Away. This was fine. I've had this for many years, and I just started putting these in my bathroom, actually, and using them as room sprays. So, yeah, it was fine, but I've got a lot more of these body sprays, or a few more of the body sprays to get through, so I won't repurchase that scent. I think that's it for Bath & Body Works. Nope. It's not. I went through a Vanilla Bean Noel lotion. And even though I prefer the triple moisture body cream or the 24-hour moisture, I'll still buy the lotions because these can go bad after about a year and a half to 2 years, whereas the lotions seem to last a really long time. So if you really like a scent and you want to get some backups because Bath & Body Works doesn't necessarily always come out with the same scents, then I would recommend getting just the lotion over the cream. But this was a scent that I had at work, and I used that up. That's the Vanilla Bean Noel. It's classic. I'll always repurchase that one. And I went through an Apple Harvest Suncrest Apple Harvest Shea and Sugar Body Scrub. I love the sugar body scrubs from Bath & Body Works. I think they're really like scrubby, and they exfoliate really well. So I'll definitely repurchase more of these. The scent was nice. I just try to look for these at semi-annual sales, and I'll get them in whatever scent I find, just because I find they don't necessarily linger on your skin, and they are really great exfoliators. So I went through one of those. I went through one pocket back in cucumber and mint. This was nice, and I'd probably purchase this scent again. It was a good one. I think that's it. I got a couple of wallflowers. Maybe just one wallflower. I think this was in the scent pumpkin apple. And again, I love that scent. I try to purchase it every year. Yep, pumpkin apple. It's just so fresh and yummy, and it's great throughout the house. So one wallflower and pumpkin apple. I went through this clear scalp and hair total care shampoo and conditioner. This was fine. I just buy whatever's on sale for shampoo and conditioner. So yeah, if this was on sale, I would purchase it again. It did an okay job. I went through a Swispers, 100 count Swispers. I got this big pack at Costco. So if you watch any of my empties videos, you know that I prefer the cotton clouds. No, is that what they're called? Not the Shiseido, but the other one that's supposed to be a dupe for Shiseido. I haven't actually purchased them in quite a while. I can't find the ones that I typically get on Amazon. So I grabbed this big pack at Costco of the Swispers. And these are just okay. I mean, they do the job. But when I'm done with these, I will probably, or most definitely, go back to the cotton clouds on Amazon that I find. But these are fine. I mean, for cotton, and it's fairly inexpensive at Costco to buy a big pack of those. I went through the Almay makeup remover wipe. This is the first of a couple of steps in my skincare. So I take off my eye makeup with an eye makeup remover, and then I take off the rest of my makeup with a wipe, and then I go on with a cleanser, and then all of my other potions and lotions and all the good stuff. So I really like this. Typically, the Costco or Kirkland brand of the makeup remover wipes are my favorite, and I prefer those, but this is definitely either tied for first or a very close second. So this is the Almay in the purple packaging, the gentle oil-free makeup remover. It works really great. I find that the towelettes stay really moist. There's a really gentle, like, light scent that I don't think is offensive at all, and it removes my makeup really, really well. So these are great. I would highly recommend these makeup wipes. I used up this Garnier Nourishing Cleansing Oil. I kept this in my shower. If I forgot to take my makeup off with a wipe before I got in the shower, I would use this before I went in and cleansed my face, just so I didn't get my Clarisonic brush head all yucky. This was fine. I don't prefer the makeup oils to take off my makeup. I think that it's just, I find that I don't like the smell of oils. So there's that one oil that everybody loves. It's an almond shower oil. And it just, ugh, I don't like the scent of it. And same thing with this. I didn't like the scent and it just kind of drove me nuts. So I think it's, in general, I don't like the scent of oils. I don't know. I won't be repurchasing. That was kind of a long, a long explanation to say I won't repurchase this. I don't like makeup remover in the oil form. So this isn't a beauty product, but it's the Method Dish Soap in Honeycrisp Apple. And I really like this Method dish soap. I think it's really nice that it has a pump on it. It's really convenient and it comes in really nice scents. So I definitely will repurchase more of the Method. Okay, so this is another non-beauty item, but it's called Wine Away. It looks like this. It's a spray bottle and you can typically find this in little like gift shops or like wineries if you go to wineries. This is excellent for removing wine if you spill it, which I have spilled many glasses of wine in my day, and so it's nice to have these on hand. I actually have another one right now, and we've gone through this whole big bottle over several years, but it works really great. So if you drink a lot of wine, or if you have company and you serve wine, this is a really good product to keep on hand. I'm sure you could probably find this online as well. I've only just bought these ever at gift shops and wineries, but that's a great product. We used up this Aveeno Baby Wash and Shampoo. I prefer the Johnson & Johnson over the Aveeno, but I got quite a bit of baby wash during my baby shower. My little guy's 15 months old at this point, and we still have a ton to go through. So I won't repurchase the Aveeno, but it works just fine. This bottle is really gross, but this is the Dove Men Care Expert Shave Oil. This was my husband's, and it's like a pre-shave oil that's supposed to soften your face and neck prior to shaving, but he never used it, so I just used it to shave my legs with, and again, the scent of it, I hated the scent of oil, but it worked fine to shave my legs, but we will not repurchase that. I went through a Sephora waterproof eye makeup remover. This is really good. I think that this might now be my favorite. It used to be the Sonia Kashuk, and I'm using that right now. And it still works really good, but I think the Sephora brand is actually my favorite eye makeup remover. So I definitely will repurchase this at some point. I went through a Scentsationals Baked Orchard Apple Wax Melt. This was a really nice scent for the fall. Not as much bakery as it is fresh apple, but there was a bakery undertone. And again, it was a really good scent. I would totally purchase that again, like next fall. I went through a Colgate Optic White. This was fine. I just buy toothpaste that's on sale, and I typically like the whitening brand or whitening kind. So either the Colgate or the Crest 3D White. Those are my two favorites. I went through a couple of these Dr. Dennis Gross Alpha Beta Peels. It's a two-step towelette, and it is a peel for your face. So you put the first towelette on, you wait a couple of minutes, and then you wipe your face down with the second towelette, and then you go in with the rest of your skincare. This is really expensive. I bought it last year at the semi-annual sale, and I'm still going through these little packets. I'm definitely not using them as frequently as I should, but again, they're expensive, so I was kind of like hoarding onto them. But yeah, I actually think these are pretty good. So someday I might repurchase them, but again, I'm still going through the ones that I bought last year at the semi-annual sale. But I would check those out if you like to invest, in expensive skincare or higher end skincare, I guess I should say. I went through this Hello Lashes, mascara by It Cosmetics, and it was fine. I won't repurchase that. I get so many mascaras in little sets that I find that I don't have to purchase mascara really that often. And if I do, I typically just buy it from the drugstore because I think there's some really good mascara at the drugstore. Here's a Bath & Body Works lid. I went through a Revlon Colorstay foundation. It wouldn't be an Empties video if there wasn't one of these in it. I go through one of these every month, and I am in the shade 250. This is a really great foundation. It's very full coverage. It doesn't feel super heavy on the face. It doesn't look cakey. I think for the drugstore and high-end, I think it's a really great option. It's about $13, but you can usually find it on sale or like buy one, get one half off. So check that out if you haven't tried that foundation. Something spilled in here and it's really gross. And it's on all of these products. But I went through a Buxom Lip Gloss in the shade Marina. And just a really pretty kind of purpley pink color. I've got a ton of Buxom lip glosses because I purchased a couple of sets, one during the VIB sale and then one this summer that they had out with summer colors. So I really love those glosses. They're tingly, plumping. They're really shiny and pretty on the lips. I think that they're a great product. So check out the Buxom lip glosses if you haven't. I went through the Paracone MD Face Finishing Moisturizer. This is just a sample size. It lasted me quite a while. I almost purchased a really big set of this on QVC at one point when my son was just a couple of months old. I was up for like a middle of the night feeding and was watching QVC, which was a bad idea because it almost made me spend like hundreds of dollars on a skincare set through Paracone MD. But I wasn't super impressed with this. Now, I know that it's a smaller size, so it's probably not a totally fair judgment of this line. Let me know what you think. If you've tried this Paracone before, what your thoughts are on it, if you think it's worth the money, because I would be curious about maybe trying some more of their products down the road. I have quite a bit of skincare right now, so I don't need it anytime soon, but let me know if you've tried it and what you think. Okay, I am throwing out this barely branded color tattoo just because it's dried up. I've used quite a bit. I hit pan on it. These are by Maybelline, I think. They're the Maybelline color tattoos. If you haven't, yep, Maybelline color tattoo. If you haven't tried these are a really great option from the drugstore, and they have really pretty colors. Bad to the Bronze is probably my favorite, and this was a really great color too. So this one, again, was barely branded. So great product from the drugstore. Check it out. I'm just throwing this away. This is some eyeshadow that I got, I think, in a Birch Box or something that totally dried up, so I have no thoughts on that. And I think the last thing I will speak to that I really have an opinion on, this is the Dollar Shave Club razor blades that come. If you're not familiar with Dollar Shave Club, you pay like $7 a month. They send you the base of a razor, like when you first sign up for the subscription service, and then once a month they send you 4 razor blades. And this is a really great, they're great razors. You never have to worry about, you know, running out or having a dull blade because they're, you know, constantly stocking you up on these, and the price point is excellent. I definitely would check it out if male or female. My husband and I actually both do Dollar Shave Club, and I think it's a great service. So I think it's just dollarshaveclub.com. I'm not affiliated with them. They have no idea who I am, but I think it's a great service, and so you should check it out. And those are all my products for the month of November. I hope that you guys are doing well. We went to a gingerbread house decorating contest last night with some friends, and it was really fun. We got first place, my husband and I. We do it every year. I think that was the 4th year we've gone to this particular, Christmas party contest. So that was a good time. And today we're just kind of hanging out at home. It's Sunday. We set up our Polar Express train for our little guy today, and he loves it. So that was really fun to see. And yeah, we have one more week of work, and then we're off for a couple of weeks for Christmas. So I hope that you guys are all doing well. I will talk to you in my next video, and Merry Christmas if I don't record before then. Bye.